joined here by Chris Lindner, who's a president of FootJoy, and we talked a year ago when you just taken office. So how's the first year been for you?
It's been incredible. It's good. First of all, it's good to see you again. Thanks again for stopping by another PGA show. It's been an incredible year, and to see some of the initiatives now come to life a year later that I remember us talking about has been really really amazing. The team at FootJoy, and I knew it then, but again now with a year more of experience working with this just an incredible team, passionate people, dedicated only to golf, creating incredible product, and now really focused on connecting with golfers all over the world. It's been an exciting year, and we're looking forward to 18.
Has anything surprised you in that year that you maybe weren't expecting?
I don't know if there's been any surprises. Certainly, I'm coming from outside the industry, and I feel like I've had some related experiences that have been helpful, but learning a lot about the golf category and industry has been great. The people, not a surprise, because I knew them, but I have to say that the quality of people and the passion and the dedication just hits me every day. We're coming off a global sales meeting for the last 5 days here in Orlando, and the energy and excitement and the enthusiasm of our team, who, by the way, have a lot of tenure and experience in the industry, just is inspirational for me. So, it's been a fantastic year.
Okay. Are we some of the key products you've got coming out this year? I mean, the Tour S is probably the shoe that's the main headline one right here right now. What is it you think that will bring to the market?
Well, Tour S was a shoe that was really inspired by working with PGA professionals, both on the European Tour and the PGA Tour here in the U.S. And in working with them, really one of the key things that they were asking for was a stable platform. And when you talk to Tour players at the highest caliber, they put their hands out almost like this, and that inspired the design, the hexagonal design for the power pods that exist on the outsole of the Tour S, and to provide them a strong, stable platform so that they can generate more power and precision has been exactly what that team achieved. And Rafa Cabrera-Bell is a great example. He's also an F1 fan, and he talked about the shoe as if, not unlike an F1 car where you place the wheels to the outside, it was one of those design opportunities that gave him the stable platform that he needs to perform in and out. So we're really excited about that launch. It launches on February 15th, just a couple weeks' time, and great excitement here. Really fun to see consumers get a first-hand chance to play and hit balls in the shoe at the demo day on Tuesday this week. So
yeah, because it's almost a trend, almost back towards the belt, because the Pro SL last year, you increased a little bit of stability on that. I mean, is this a longer-term trend, you think, towards it?
Yeah, I think, as you know, we work with different players and different swing types, and there are some swing types that respond more to the stable platform. There are other types of golfers. Adam Scott's a good example. He helped a lot with the design input to Tour S, but he recognizes that he's got very quiet feet throughout the swing, probably the most quiet feet on tour. So Pro SL is a shoe that he feels really comfortable in, plenty of traction, but enough new stability so that a golfer, obviously at his level, is getting exactly what he needs from performance out of that shoe. So it's exciting. Obviously, we're focused on providing solutions for golfers at all levels, and so we have a great range.
Well, you've been very big in clothing in the last few years, but now we've got this 1857 range here. Do you want to explain a bit about the name and what the range is about?
Yeah, no, it's, well, this has been exciting for us to launch at this show. 1857 is the original founding year of FootJoy, and so in many ways, this is an opportunity to sort of celebrate what's really in our heart and the passion of FootJoy, which is making quality golf shoes from the beginning. We've been dedicated to golf for over 160 years, and so in 1857, original founder Fred Packer opened a factory in Brockton, Massachusetts that was making the original FootJoy shoes. Now this year, we're returning to kind of the classic styling that we're hearing so many dedicated golfers say, hey, I'm really interested in that, and so we've partnered with a third generation footwear maker out of Italy who's bringing the finest Italian calfskin materials and craft. We're creating Goodyear welted product. We're using the original last called the Aintree last that we established in Brockton, Massachusetts, and we're making the shoes the same way that we did back in the original factory. So it's very exciting to launch that and getting a lot of excitement and energy for that shoe. And we surround founded the collection because we're a head-to-toe wearables brand with a luxury performance collection of apparel, and it's just exquisite materials, Supima cottons and cashmeres, and it just really brings the entire collection to life. And so we're launching it here at the trade show in February. It'll deliver in U.S. markets only in 18 in July for the fall season, and then we'll open up distribution in 19 outside of the U.S.
So I suppose it's quite a premium range, isn't it? So is it going to be available in lots of places, or are you got a fairly restricted distribution?
We see it being distributed at kind of the fine quality clubs around the world. And so I think it'll be a much smaller collection of clubs ultimately. But obviously we're going to go where that dedicated golfer who is demanding of these luxury materials and this type of look and feel will be most interested in the product.
And in terms of selling direct and online, I don't know if this is part of it, but if it is, or the rest of the range, how is that going for you?
Going very well. We do sell direct in the U.S. in key markets in Europe as well as Canada. 1857 will be part of that collection. As you know, though, especially with our apparel, over 70% of our apparel is customized to the club, and I think that's really where we're excited about this line, to support those better clubs where their members and their guests of members kind of are looking for that special piece from a Pine Valley or a Cypress or some of the better clubs in the world. So we'll embellish the product, and we see a lot of custom opportunities around that to support our best PGA Tour members.
I think Simon, last year I think I was asked about technology and clothing and whether we see any sort of sensors or tracking. Are you any further down the road with any of that stuff?
Doing a lot of advanced concept work from a material story across our entire line, and especially on the rainwear and outerwear front. So we've had some really great advances over the year for FootJoy outerwear. We're a leader here in North America, but we think that's a really exciting next opportunity for us. This time next year, I'll have some exciting things to share with you, I'm sure.
Well, that's great. We'll look forward to that. Well, thanks for watching your time.
Yeah, great seeing you again. Yeah, appreciate everything.